Ask us about this nation. The dirty is little secret. Oh, that is plenty of mass. Shut up about the impact we have our children. Someone has not talked to our children or seen them in years. I have not seen or talked to my children in over 3 years. I actually have joint custody. I'm from Michigan. There's three other women here from Michigan. This is Maria. She was beat up by her father's mom. Her back was broken. She has not seen her children in 2 years. The judge put her in jail for not seeing child support because she was smoking a cigarette. He said that she should have thrown that cigarette and paid her child support.
My name is Mary Richardson. I'm from New York State. I left my batterer when my daughter was 2 and my son was 3 and a half. I lost custody after I brought forth that he was having showers with our children. I was told by my attorney I should have never said anything. My children are 15 and 17. We're both still struggling and living with a batterer and sexual abuser. I lost custody of my daughter, but she revealed that she was being sexually abused by her biological father. I have to pay supervised monitors to see my daughter. I live in the state of California. They have told me that if I discuss this, that I am crazy. I have medical records. My daughter begs me every time that I see her to please save her.
My personal favorite little story of the White House is the story of President William Howard Taft.
He was not by any means the most
famous president.
When Taft was abused by his biological father,
Taft was on fast
too at the time. They forced me into supervised visitation for 3 and a half years. It was torture. He ran to me and clung to me every time. I haven't seen him now for 4 years. He's 10 years old. And I have been fighting the courts to the tune of over $150,000. Family courts need to be abolished. They are lawless courts. We don't need them.
Or high school or whatever. Actually, she drunk half enough to be in the bathtub. This was, as I'm sure you can imagine, very embarrassing to pass.
Please help the children. Please help expose this. They have put gag orders on some of us. They have threatened. We are not allowed to see our children. We have done nothing but try to protect our children from abusive and dangerous and violent and very bad situations. Please, predators. And now they are forced to live with them. They have no hope. They are hostages. Please help to expose this. Please. We need citizens. We need voices. They have ripped our hearts. Please help us. We won't give up. Please help our children. They are the next generation. Please. Remember, our law comes from the church. Every time you read the law, it goes back to the Bible. We've all lost our children, and we're good mothers. Been jailed. Our identity's been taken. Our children have been taken. I say into these eyes, let the blind eyes see. Let the deaf ear hear. For we will speak and you will not have an understanding of what's happening today in this United States of America. They're trading us. They're practicing commerce law. I'm from Oklahoma. It's the largest state for trafficking of humans.
Jennifer's mother was a good mother.
My name is Jennifer Collins. When my brother was 4 years old, my father beat him so badly that he fractured his skull. But yet, when I was 7 and my brother was 9, the family court system turned custody over to our abusive father, who the court found had committed domestic violence. My mother had to flee the country with us in 1994, and we had to live as refugees in the Netherlands in order to finally be free from domestic violence. This happens all across the United States. Every single state has children who are being handed over to their abusers, who are being molested and beaten every day. It's time that we stand up and protect our children. They're speaking out, they're telling us about the abuse, and they're still being ignored. These mothers here have been good mothers, like my mother, and believed their children when their child told them they were being abused. But still, the family court takes their children away and gives them to the abuser. So I think it's time that the world knows and the United States stands up and doesn't allow this to happen anymore. We need to listen to the children and protect them.
Maria wants to talk. Oh, okay.
Don't worry, guys.
Here, I'll take it. No. I want you to get it.
No, I don't
want
to do it.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
We need people to call their congressmen and ask for an oversight hearing to look into the abuses of family court across this country. We have lost our civil rights and the right to protect our children, and we need your help. We need you to call your representatives and ask them to stop this abuse and protect our children. In every state in this United States, this democracy, we need you to participate. We need you to help our children. Please help us. This is what you can do. We are trying to protect our children and your children. Help us do the same.
My son committed suicide after going to live with his father, and he couldn't take the abuse. It was so bad. His conditions of living, what he was forced to live in, the abuse was so terrible that he took his own life 2 years ago. He had just turned 18 years old. My youngest son has been abused more than four times. Child Protective Services is fully aware of this. They've been contacted by pastors, they've been contacted by professionals, by doctors, yet they refuse to do anything about it. When they did try to step in and do something about it, the family court judge put the children back in the home with the abuser. This has taken place all over. These children are in danger. These children are going to grow up to marry your children, and they will know nothing but abuse. We need to stop what's going on now before it affects the whole nation. Thank you.
Even if this doesn't affect you, I promise you that it does. Violent crimes are committed by people, by children that grow up witnessing domestic violence, by children that grow up in abusive households. Violent crimes are committed. Sociopaths are created by that type of environment. Animal abuse, children, adults that are abusive to animals, to your children when they're married, they will follow in the same repetition. Please help us. Please help us so this travesty will come to an end. We need everybody.